In SwiftUI, view value and view identity are two distinct concepts that play a vital role in managing state and designing dynamic interfaces. A view's value represents its current state at a given moment, essentially a snapshot of its configuration. In contrast, a view's identity persists over time, connecting these individual states and providing continuity. Understanding these concepts is important for designing view hierarchies with predictable and stable behavior, and for avoiding frustration when debugging issues like unexpected loss of state, broken transitions, or views not updating as expected. Let's take a closer look at how view value and view identity work and why this distinction matters in real SwiftUI apps.
Here we have a very simple ticking counter view that updates every second. We increment the count on each timer sequence iteration, and SwiftUI makes sure that the displayed text refreshes with every update. The body of the view is recomputed whenever the state variable count changes. That produces a new value of the view, a fresh snapshot of its structure. SwiftUI compares this new value to the previous one to determine what needs to change on screen. In this case, it detects that the text has changed and updates the displayed number accordingly. Let's see what happens when we embed this view into a larger view hierarchy. The styled ticking counter view allows users to pick a color for the UI. The selected color is stored in the view's state, and every time it changes in response to a tab, SwiftUI reevaluates the view's body. This results in a new value for styled ticking counter and its child views. But the identity of the ticking counter remains the same across these updates. We can tell this is the case because the counter doesn't reset. It keeps incrementing continuously, even as the color changes. If the identity had changed, the counter would have restarted from zero. It's important to note, however, that view identity is not the same as the instance of the view struct. Every time the body of the styled ticking counter view is reevaluated, a new instance of ticking counter is created. We can easily prove this point by putting a print statement inside the ticking counter initializer. Now, every time we change the color in the styled ticking counter view, we'll see ticking counter initialized printed in the console. SwiftUI doesn't preserve the identity of views by storing or reusing the actual struct instances. Instead, it tracks identity through internal bookkeeping, often using things like the position in the hierarchy, view type, and any explicitly provided identifiers. As long as SwiftUI considers the ticking counter to have the same identity as before, it preserves the associated state, like the current count. This is why the counter keeps ticking. Even though the ticking counter struct is recreated, its identity in the SwiftUI view hierarchy is stable. And this is also why we should avoid putting heavy logic in view initializers. SwiftUI expects view creation to be lightweight. Putting expensive work in the initializer means it will run repeatedly, even though the identity and associated state of the view might be preserved. Now, let's see what happens when the identity of the view is not preserved. In this styled counter or symbol example, we've added a toggle counter button that lets the user switch between the ticking counter and the rotating symbol. Inside the view body, we use an if statement to conditionally include either ticking counter or rotating symbol based on the show counter state. What we observe is that every time the counter reappears, it starts from zero again. That's because when the condition becomes false and the ticking counter is removed from the hierarchy, SwiftUI discards its identity and, along with it, any associated state. When the condition becomes true again, a new ticking counter is created with a fresh identity and new state. This highlights the importance of designing our view hierarchy thoughtfully if we want to avoid unexpected behavior like state resetting. If we want to preserve a view's identity with the state and any long-running tasks, like the timer sequence in our ticking counter, we can choose to hide and show the view by adjusting its opacity instead of using an if statement. In this case, the state won't reset and the counter will keep incrementing even while the view is hidden. That's because the view stays in the hierarchy, so its identity is preserved. SwiftUI continues to manage its state and any running tasks. If we don't have any long-running tasks associated with the view, or if we don't want them to keep running while the view is hidden, and we only care about preserving state, we can leave the state up to the parent and pass it down as a binding. In this case, even if the child view is removed and then re-added to the hierarchy, the state remains preserved in the parent. This ensures continuity of data, even though the child view's identity doesn't persist between updates.
If you would like to dive deeper into the SwiftUI view lifecycle, update mechanisms, and view identity, you can learn more in my book SwiftUI Fundamentals. You can find the link to it in the video description. Understanding these concepts can save you a lot of frustration when building and debugging your SwiftUI projects. Thank you for watching. I hope you found this video useful. See you next time.